What's new, fat hay?
Today on Action Figure Times, the Young Justice Marathon continues with Icicle Jr. Hi, I'm Doc Owen with Action Figure Times. I hope you're enjoying Young Justice Marathon with everything we've got going on. If this is your first time tuning in for the marathon, we are having giveaways, and we're going to tell you about more about that at the end of the show. We've got 6-inch toys. We've got the 4-inch. We've got singles. We've got 2-packs. We've got something that I know you're going to want to have. We also want to thank once again Mattel for providing us with interviews and different things. We also thank EnchantedToyChest.com for all of their support. Scott and the guys are always very, very good to us, and they are my personal recommendation for an e-tailer. Now, I love the way they package stuff and send it out. Speaking of packaging, this is going to be our first time really examining the packaging of the Young Justice line. When I did Aqualad, which was the first figure in the wave, Icicle Jr. is the second figure. I really was getting more into the figure, and we could just kind of jump in. But now, as we're moving along, let's look at the packaging. The packaging is about the same size, at least height-wise, maybe a little shorter. I haven't been able to compare it than the JLU packaging. It is kind of similar to the JLU packaging as far as the colors, don't you think? That's kind of the way I look at it. Now, the up here in the corner, you find out, this tells you that you can get a Collect and Connect piece for the Hall of Justice, which is really one of the coolest things. I've even heard of people buying these figures and then selling the figure itself just to get the Hall of Justice. Of course, I want to hold on to my figures because I like these representations of the characters, at least as far as their appearance. Now, this is significantly thicker than the regular JLU packaging because there's that piece of the Hall of Justice in there. Down here you've got the Young Justice logo, and then you have the name of the character that you're going to be getting. The back, you have a little bit of a bio. This tells a little bit about Icicle Jr. and the fact that he had a real bad dad, but he still wanted to be like him anyway. And this shows the waves that are coming. Now, according to this, the back of this, Icicle Jr. is the second figure in the wave, and so we're going to go ahead and look at it. One other thing that's kind of cool looking at the packaging, and we talked about this last time we looked at this, is there is an insert card in here that actually disguises itself very well. They did very good at, as you turn it, you can kind of see how there's a piece right behind Icicle. And then there's the actual card itself. They didn't actually, that's a pretty cool deal given to you. But let's go ahead and open him up. Once again, I don't know whether I've mentioned it since then. Right here is a little graphic that tells you which piece of the Hall of Justice that you'll be getting. Now, we're getting, as it said, one of the sides. Actually, this connects, I believe. Yeah, this actually connects to this piece, and so I'm now just, which I'm actually grateful for, I'm only 2 figures into the line, and I'm able to begin to assemble my Hall of Justice. So that's pretty cool. I like it, you know. I don't like to get 10 figures in the wave and I can't put anything together. What am I talking about? Green Lantern Movie Masters, of course. Now, again, on the back, I've got a little bit of a sheet. Tells me what piece I got and where it goes. Now, as we open up Icicle Jr., he does have an accessory with him. Remember, Calder, Aqualad from the series, had an accessory with him. It was his sword. Icicle has an icicle. More like an ice stalk. Now, as you look at him here, he's a pretty... he's a pretty decent looking sculpt. They added a couple pieces to his hips. You can see right there, icicles coming out. He's got kind of a translucent arm with a translucent icicle or ice shard. That's kind of neat. He looks more of an adult, to be honest with you, than a kid. He's got a cool looking little ice arm. You can see those Freddy Krueger type fingers right there. That's kind of neat. Obviously, we'll talk about articulation another time, but it's pretty much non-existent. The face sculpt, I like it. This is somebody actually that could probably go fight Thor from the Ice Giants or something like that. But he looks a little bit too adultish to me. But all in all, he's a pretty cool figure. Again, just like Calder, he's not wearing shoes. I'm not exactly sure why. Does being an ice guy protect your feet? I can see Aqualad not having it because, I mean, dude, he's in the water all the time. But I don't understand why he doesn't have it. He's kind of got elfin ears here. I guess if you're, maybe he is one of the frost giants or something like that. I guess if you're going to be a, if you're going to be a one of these guys, you're going to be like a you know, an ice guy, you're going to have elf ears. I've never quite understood that. It just seems like the only person, Mr. Freeze, he doesn't have elf-like ears, but why is that? But anyway, I digress greatly. Let's go ahead and take a look at him close up. So here we are looking at a frost giant, from Icicle Jr. from the Young Justice universe. But hey, he does look like a frost giant, doesn't he? Got his little elfin ears, decent looking face. He does look older to me, though. He's got plenty of ice protrusions around. Now check this hand out. You gotta wonder if he has regular hands when he's not all iced up, but man, he's got some claws there. One thing about these, they might not have articulation, but I guess because of the cheapness of the plastic, their arms move around a lot. That's kind of cool, though. There you see his other hand is translucent as well. He's got his ice shard that you can put in there. He's got a little bit of ice protruding from his waist. And he's got bare feet. I just don't know about that. Well, I hope you've enjoyed looking at Icicle. Make sure you tune in tomorrow. We'll have other great stuff for you. Also, go to our forums. Make sure you're participating. I'd love to see you win something from our Young Justice giveaways. Also, tell all your friends about us because we're looking out for you and we want to give you the best reviews from the most toys from around the world. And the more hits we have, the more activity we have, the more we can do that for you. Also, remember to go to EnchantedToyChest.com. Check out what Scott and the boys have. Let them know that Doc sent you. This is Doc Owen reminding you to be extraordinary. Coming up, we'll tell you how you can win some Young Justice stuff. See you tomorrow. Hi, I'm Doc Owen with Action Figure Times. We just took a look at Icicle, but now let's talk to the gentleman that made him. Bill, tell us about him.
All righty. So here we have Icicle Jr., son of the Icicle.
All right.
You know, he's got a great sort of ice elf look to him with these spiky icicle hair shapes, his pointed ears, his sharp and pointed eyebrows, and of course, because he's transforming himself into a coating of ice, he's got this cool semi-translucent ice attack arm.
See, to me, that looks Freddy from Nightmare on Elm Street.
Very much so. It's got that extra claw length. Mm-hmm. You know, over here, he's creating an icicle for throwing with his hand. And of course, he's barefoot so that he can get a little less traction and glide on his feet. So,
yeah, but you know he's also a criminal, right? I mean,
this is true. He is the son of the Icicle who's in prison. So you know it could be that he just can't afford shoes. Who knows?
That's a tip, kids. If you're going to be a criminal, that you could end up without shoes.
Avoid a life of ice crime, no matter what.
Now the colorations and things. Now to me, he actually looked a little bit more adult than some of the other figures. Is he a more mature character, or is he a little bit older?
Well, I think he's seen a lot on the show. You know, he's a criminal.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
He's had a hard upbringing, and that really comes through in his face with the narrowed brow and the more intense look. He's definitely not happy-go-lucky.
Awesome. So. Well, very good. Well, thanks, Bill.
Cool. Thank you.
And we'll see you tomorrow on Action Figure Times. Hi, I'm Doc Owen with Action Figure Times. We hope you're enjoying the Young Justice Marathon. Now, as you know, at AF Times, we like to give away stuff. Every week, Prize Monkey's giving something away in the Prize Monkey Palace. But in honor of the marathon, we're going to be giving away this two-pack, Aquaman and Aqualad, that I know you're going to want to have. Now, in order to win, you actually have to become a member of our forums. Once you do, right after the community section will be something that shows up, and it'll say Prize Monkey Palace. Now, in there, you'll find a thread, and it'll talk about Doc's Capture the Caption contest for Young Justice Marathon. There'll be two pictures there that you have to write a caption to. Whoever has the most entertaining, the most hilarious captions, you'll win the contest, and we'll send this directly to your home postage page. Now, you have between now and September 4th at 12 midnight Pacific Standard Time in order to participate in the contest. Now, you do have to join our forums, but it's not hard. It's just simple, man. And then you get a chance that you can win this and see some really great stuff. We'll announce the winner on Monday, September 5th. I hope you win. I also want to thank EnchantedToyChest.com for providing all these very, very cool prizes. In addition, I want to remind you that during Young Justice Marathon, we're going to have some exclusive reveals that you're not going to want to miss. Some really exciting news, plus comments from Bill Benecke, and Mike Guarneri is actually going to give us a romp through how to make a toy. We'll see you tomorrow on Action Figure Times.